Take your new class. Public static void being finish. Now let me explain you the manual test case first. First I need to open the browser, then I need to open the URL called krninformatics.com/sample.html. Now I need to verify whether this checkbox is selected or not. If it is selected, I want to print as pass, or else I want to print as fail. In that case, what to do? First, open the browser, open the URL. Identify this checkbox. Right click, inspect. And verify whether this checkbox is selected or not. If it is selected, I want to print as pass, or else I want to print as if it is selected, I want to print as true, or else I want to print as false. How to do that? That is what we are going to see. First, open the browser. Web driver, driver equal to new Firefox driver, driver dot get, and open the URL. Web driver, driver equal to new Firefox driver, then driver dot get, then I need to identify this checkbox. Right click, inspect, identify this checkbox. ID equal to REM. Driver dot find element by dot ID equal to REM. ID equal to REM dot is selected. See, if I want to click, I can use dot click. If I want to type something, I am using dot send keys. Now, either I don't want to click on this element, or else I don't want to type. I want to verify whether that is selected or not. If you want to verify whether that is selected or not, in that case, I can use a method called isSelected method. Which returns Boolean. If true, the checkbox is selected, and false if checkbox is not selected. In that case, Boolean checkbox status. Now, see, isSelected method, it clearly shows that isSelected method, it returns a Boolean. Since it returns a Boolean, I have to hold that in a Boolean variable. Boolean means true or false. Checkbox status. Then run this. Browser, open the URL. And print as false. Why it is printed as false? Can someone tell me why it is printed as false? We didn't do any manual actions. By default, the checkbox is not selected. That's why. Are you getting me what I'm telling? Yes or no? Yes. Yes. Next. it's what I have to do here is I need to click on the checkbox. I need to click on the checkbox. Okay, I need to click on the checkbox and identify the status again. How will I click on the checkbox? I need to identify the status. I have ID for that element. How to click on that element? Can you tell me how to click on that element?
Checkbox status.
Checkbox status. Is it a web element?
Create a web element for that.
Why? Okay, use driver.findElement itself directly.
Yeah, we can.
Driver.findElement by dot ID REM dot. What I can use? If I want to click on the dot, click, so that it will click. After clicking, again I need to identify that element and identify the status. Then how to do that? Can you tell me? Don't copy and all. Tell me, if I copy paste, then with first program itself, I will complete the complete syllabus itself. Driver dot find element by dot ID REM dot. Is selected. Very good. Is selected. What does this returns?
It's a boolean.
It returns boolean. Very good. It returns boolean. Hold that in a boolean variable. That is checkbox status. One. System.out.println checkbox status 1. Now if I run this, first it will print as false. Then it will click on the checkbox and it will print as true.
Open the browser. There you are.
And click on the checkbox. Done. False and click on the checkbox and true. Done. It is doing very quickly. If you want to see the execution slowly, then I can use thread.sleep for some 3 seconds. Then you can see the execution slowly also. Open the browser, open the URL, false and check the checkbox and true, done. Need to click on the driver again. I need to click on the driver dot find element by dot ID equal to REM dot click, so that it will uncheck. So that it will uncheck again. I need to identify the status driver dot find element by ID equal to REM dot is selected. What does this is selected method returns? It returns boolean. Hold that in a boolean variable, that is checkbox status. System.out.println checkbox status 2. That's it. Let me run this. Open the browser. False. And click on the checkbox true. Again click on the checkbox, it will uncheck and it will print as false. This is how you verify whether a checkbox is selected or not. We can use driver.findElement to find the element and use the method isSelected, which will return a boolean. If true, the checkbox is selected, and false if checkbox is unselected. That is what we will be doing here. Right? Next, the same thing, can we do that for the radio button? I need to do that for the radio button. First, open the browser, open the URL, identify the radio button and print status. Again, identify the radio button and print the status. Right click, new, class, demo, radio. Admin, finish. Now, WebDriver, driver equal to new, Firefox, driver. then driver dot get and open the URL. Driver dot get and open the URL. Then I need to identify this radio button. Right click, inspect, identify the radio button. Identify the radio button. If I want to identify the radio button, I can use I equal to female. Driver dot find element by dot ID equal to female. Driver dot find element by ID equal to female dot is selected. What does this is selected method returns? It returns boolean. Hold that in a boolean variable, that is radio status. System.out.println radio status. Then thread.sleep for some 3 seconds. Then again I need to click on that dot click. Then again I need to identify the status. How? Radio status 1, radio status 1. It's 2 and radio status 2. I am doing that again. Run this. Open the browser, open the URL. False, true, and true it is printing. Actually, we have expected false, true, false, but it is printing as false, true, true. Why? Can you tell me why? Because this is a radio button. If it is a checkbox, one time it will check, one time it will uncheck. But when you come to the radio button, right, even if you click 100 times also, it won't uncheck. It will only check. Have you understood this?
Yeah.
Yes. To do that, then let us see some notes for this. In that case, element checkpoints. How do you verify whether a checkbox is selected or not? We can use driver.findElement to find the checkbox and use the method isSelected, which will return a boolean if true the checkbox is selected and false if checkbox is unselected. Take note of this. Someone is asking something?
Yes, Zain
here. Yeah, tell me, Zain.
Can you please open the
door? Okay. Only take down these notes. Take down the program. Don't take down the program.
Okay.
Program, I'll take down the live program. Okay. There is a lot of difference between a checkbox and a radio button. That's why I've created both the programs here. Completed? Take down this. you completed this program? Yes or no?
Yes. Let me get to the next program.
Take down this radio button program, and below this checkbox program, leave some 3 to 4 lines of gap. I will fill that gap after 5 minutes. Then take down the radio button program. Okay, done. Next. See, is this checkbox status is true or false? Whatever I have selected, this is this true or false? Can you tell me? It's false. Is checkbox status 1 is true or false? True. Is checkbox status 2 is true or false? True. Checkbox status. Is it true or false, guys? False. When I run this, it will print as false, true and false. First it is print false, then it has printed as true. Again it will click on the checkbox and it will print as false. False, true and false. False, true and false. Now, if I am going to make if condition, if checkbox status 2, will this condition will enter inside this if condition? Will the condition will enter inside this? No. Why? Checkbox status 2 is false. That's why it won't enter inside that condition. But if it is false, which means that if it is not selected, I want to enter inside that condition. In that case, what I can do? Not of. Very good. Not of. Not of checkbox status 2. So that it will enter inside this. See, my only final goal is at the end of this checkbox program, if the checkbox is not selected, please mute your microphone, those who are having disturbance. If the checkbox is not selected, I want to click on the checkbox and I have to go in, go to the next step. Okay, at the end of the program, if it is not selected, I want to click on that and I have to go next. If it is selected, I don't want to do anything. If it is selected, I don't want to do anything in that case. Driver dot find element by dot id equal to rem dot click. Now what happens at the end of this checkbox program? If the checkbox is not selected, it will click on the checkbox and come out. But if the checkbox is selected already, right, it won't do anything. Because if it is selected, then it will be true. Not true in the sense it will become false. Then it won't enter inside this condition. Already I have taught you how if condition works. That I have implemented in the checkbox program here. I didn't do anything beyond that. Understood clearly, everyone? Below the existing checkbox program, add this line. Next. Now, next, to verify, I need to open the browser, open the URL called demo.actitime.com. Open the browser, open the URL called demo.actitime.com. Open the URL called demo.actitime.com. I need to verify whether logo is displayed or not. Verify whether logo is displayed or not. If logo is displayed there, then I want to print as true, or else I want to print as false. In that case, what to do? That is what we are going to see now. Right click, inspect. Class equal to next, I need to open the browser and URL, then I need to verify whether that logo is displayed or not. Right click, new class, demo, logo, public static void main, finish. Next, web driver, driver equal to new, Firefox driver, then driver dot get, and open the URL. Let me open the URL. After opening the browser and URL, I need to identify this element. After identifying this element, I need to verify whether that is displayed or not. In that case, this element doesn't have ID and name, and it is not a link also to identify the link text. That's why I am using XPath. This is the XPath for that element. Okay, those who don't know XPath, I'll teach you later how to write the XPath. Don't worry. Wait for me. Now you can take this as a XPath. Now, driver dot find element by dot XPath dot. I am going to use the method isDisplayed. What does this isDisplayed method returns? It returns boolean. Okay, it returns boolean. Since it returns a boolean, hold that in a boolean variable. Boolean logo status. System.out.println logo status. Now it will print as true. That's it. That is what it is going to happen. This is how we can verify whether logo is displayed or not. Open the browser, open the URL, demo.actitime.com. Then it is displaying as true. That's it. This is how to verify whether logo is displayed or not. Next, take down. How do you verify whether logo is displayed or not? How do you verify whether logo is displayed or not? How to verify whether logo is displayed or not? We can use driver.findElement to find the element. Driver.findElement to find the element and use the method isDisplayed, and use the method. We can use driver.findElement to find the element. We can use driver.findElement to find the element. We can use driver.findElement to find the element and use the method isDisplayed. which returns boolean. Which returns boolean if true. The logo is displayed. If true, the logo is displayed, and false if logo is not displayed. Take down this program.